So in this session, I'm going to talk about customers. When we want to create a customer record, we're going to go to customers. And when you click on customers, it's going to give you a list of all your existing customers with its specific information on the list view. If I want to create a new customer, I'm going to create a new. And you'll see what pops up in this example is I have what's called templates that you could set up specific for your company, and you can have as many different templates as you want. What the template does, the template allows you to put in specific defaults to make sure that all the information gets populated, at least all the important information gets populated. For example, payment terms code, maybe 1099 code, maybe a certain number series, a payment method, etc. And let me show you what I mean. So I got two different types of customers in this example. I have a business-to-business customer or a cash payment customer. So if I go up to Actions and Edit, it's going to show me all my information that's within this template. So obviously, you're not going to default your city information, address information. But if I scroll down, because posting, general posting groups and customer posting groups are a mandatory field, we want to make sure that we put in that mandatory code so that way it's not forgotten. Maybe I want to have whether they're tax liable. All my customers are always tax liable. Maybe I have a certain price group, discount group, etc. Currency. You know, here's my payment terms, payment method, etc. So you have certain fields that are required or recommended that you always populate on the customer card, and you can set those defaults here on a template, on a template by template basis. So you're in this example, because I have two templates, I could have three, four, five different templates if I wanted to based on a different type of customer. So I choose which template I want. And lo and behold, it created a new customer number with, you know, C0040. And now all I have to do is add my name of my customer. So I got my name. I could set a credit limit. Again, this could default as well within your template. But let's just say, hey, my credit limit is going to be $1,000 for this customer. And again, this could be defaulted in based on the template if I wanted to. Keep in mind, what people don't realize is a credit limit of zero on a customer, if you choose to use credit limits for notification purposes, zero really means unlimited credit. So you won't get any notification if, in fact, they went over. So the way around that is you just put a dollar or a penny or something like that. So that way, any sales order or sales invoice that goes over a dollar, you get notified that, hey, they've exceeded their credit limit. Hence, really, a dollar is almost like saying no credit, right? We could block a customer, and block is, you know, block shipments, invoices, or all. And the difference between that is all means I'm blocking all transactions. I'm not going to take receipts from them. I'm not going to invoice them. I'm not going to take orders from him. Whereas if I want to do invoice or ship, then basically I could say I'm going to stop all shipments to this customer, but they owe us money. So I'm going to, when I get the money from them, I'll still be able to post to this customer only for cash purposes, only when we receive money. But when it comes to that, but here I'm going to say, no, I can't, I'm not going to ship any more product until I get my money. Okay. So this will block shipments and invoicing when it comes to customers, but yet you'll still accept the monies. And blank is obviously open. Of course, you have the address and contact information. Pretty self-explanatory. Address 1, address 2, city, state, zip. Who's your primary contact? His or her phone number, email, fax, etc. All right, pretty self. I'm not going to bother populating those in there. Here is my posting groups. These two fields are mandatory fields. What they do, and I'll talk about more in detail in another session, but my business posting group is a code that actually links to your revenue account, where meaning that every time I post a transaction to this customer, the impact, your GL impact, will go to what revenue or potentially cost of sales accounts. Whereas the customer posting group is you could dictate what AR GL account it could go to, because in theory you could have 2, 3, 4 different AR accounts, typically not common, but you can, and this would dictate the type of customer it is, goes to which specific AR trade account it goes to. If they're tax liable, you say yes, they are. This is turned off. This is turned on. And then if they are tax liable, to which area are they tax liable in? Oh, this customer is within the Miami, Florida. So now, based on this, this information will default on the sales orders, just like all this information defaults on the sales orders or sales invoices. So that way, when you sell to this customer, it will automatically get taxed the Miami, Florida tax. If in fact you are taxable, but they're exempt, then you can turn this off, which means the system will not charge taxable, but still track taxes within Miami, but just not charge the customer. And you can have your tax exemption, the customer's tax exemption number. If in fact you deal with currencies, we'll talk about that in a different session. You could decide what currency code they belong to. And if you want to offer them special pricing and special discounts, which again, we'll talk in a different session as well, we could set up special pricing or special discounts for this customer. Payments tab, you'll see if it's a prepayment. If you offer prepayments, then we could also say that, we expect when we sell to this customer, when we want 50% upfront or maybe 100% upfront, anything between 0 and 100, then the system will say, oh, I need to send them a prepayment invoice. And again, we'll talk about that in another session. Payment terms, as you see, payment method, all these, I didn't populate these because these came in from the template. If you want to charge finance charges, send reminder terms, again, you could saw all that as populated. Okay. If the customer wants us to print a customer statement, this is used for filtering. So that way, if you want to do a mass batch of customer statements, it's going to go through all the customers that are triggered as yes as statements. So when you print statements, you can say, yes, go print out statements for all my customers that want statements. Yeah, turn it on or off. So that's really the customer. That's the main fields within the customer card. Over here on the side of the customer card, you could also see the sales history. In this case, because it's a new customer, it's all zeros. But you could see if there's any posted invoices, posted receipts, ongoing sales orders, etc. And based on all these, you can just click on it. If there's an ongoing sales order, you'll see a list of any orders that are actually open and ongoing for that customer. So it's easy, one click, and you're there and get all the information. Down here, you get customer statistics. And let me see if I can go back and let's find one that has actually numbers. Let's see. Let me get out of here and let's go to this one, School of Fine Arts. And you'll see here an example. Oh, they have two ongoing sales invoices. They have one ongoing order. And I could just, you see 60 posted invoices, so they're fairly active. And here's all the posted invoices that I could actually go back and see the original invoice that they purchased. As I scroll down further, here's my customer statistics. Not only shows my balance, but what's outstanding for orders, what's outstanding for invoices, how much payments I received from them, when was the last payment I received from them, and what's overdue from them. So you'll see a lot of nice, quick information based on the customer that you're on. Okay. For my customer card, I could also go to New Document, which if I click on New Document, this says, oh, what do you want to do? Since I'm on the School of Fine Arts, I could automatically create a sales quote, sales invoice, order, credit memo, or reminder, and whichever one I choose, it's going to open up the sales order, and it's going to automatically populate. Oops. Let's do that again. It's going to automatically populate the information of the customer that you're on. So all you have to do is go directly to the lines and enter the detail of the lines of what they're purchasing. Okay. That's a look at the customers at a high level. We have more sessions regarding customers with other sessions, i.e. sales pricing, sales discounts, etc. So thanks for watching. If we could further assist you, please reach out to us here at epcgroup.net.